Right, let's see if we can get going then. Looks like it's working. Share that to my page. There we go. We're off. Good health to you all. Alcohol-free wine tonight, Sauvignon Blanc. Songs and Stories, number 53. Gonna keep it chilled tonight. Good evening, Roger. Good evening, Charlotte. Good evening, Fred. Greetings from the Isle, Fred. Greetings from East North Hants. As far East North Hants as you can get. That's where I live. So I hope you're all doing well on this Monday evening. It feels very autumnal tonight, doesn't it? It really does. And yeah, it's definitely... The season is turning, so I'm going to play you a few chill tunes tonight. And see how we get on. Next song is a cover. It's actually a Psychedelic Furs song. But I'm going to be playing you an arrangement that Counting Crows did. And it was a B-side actually of a cassette. I think it's a B-side Around Here or Rain King, one of the two. But it went on to feature on the late 90s film called called Clueless, which featured Reese Witherspoon in it. It's got a great soundtrack, actually. Some good songs in it. It's called Ghost in You. Man in my shoes runs a light. All the papers lie tonight. Falling over you is the news of the day. Angels fall like rain. Love is all of heaven away. Inside you, the time moves and she don't fade. The ghost in you, she don't fade. The race is on, I'm on your side, but hearing you, my engines died. I'm in the mood for you, or for running away. All the stars come down in you, but love, love, you can't give it away. And inside you, the time moves and she don't fade. The ghost in you, she don't fade. Inside you, the time moves, she don't fade away. Don't you know she don't fade? So don't you go, makes no sense, and all these talking supermen. Just take away the time, just to get it away. Love, love is only heaven away. And inside you, the time moves, she don't fade. The ghost in you, she don't fade away. Inside you, the time. Ghost in you, she don't fade. A man in my shoes runs a light. All the papers lie tonight. But falling over you is the news of the day. Love will never fade away. Love, love, love will not fade away. Roger says, yes, autumnal, happy Halloween. Well, the season starts in the States around now. Well, I'll tell you what, I work in a petrol station. This is scary, right? This is scary to Halloween. We've had our Christmas stuff already to put on the shelves in the shop before the Halloween stuff. How insane is that? On Friday, we got the first Christmas stuff and no Halloween stuff yet. So they've got it all wrong. All the wrong. We'll probably get Valentine's stuff day next or Easter or something. Alice. Hi, Alice. Are you both keeping well? So that was the Counting Crows arranged cover of Psychedelic First song, Ghost in You, and I love that song. I've been thinking about what I'm going to do in the future, and I don't know if I mentioned it last time, but the thought that I've got is maybe in the new year to release an acoustic album. A kind of like best of songs or stories, and I might feature some covers and maybe some stripped down arrangements of the band's songs and maybe some old ones. And maybe release a couple of albums next year that are just stripped down songs and stories, acoustic stuff. Charlotte says the Christmas songs will be in the stores by November. Not in our shop, they won't, I tell you. I'm very fortunate that we don't have music in our shop. It would drive me bloody mad, Charlotte. It really would. So I had a good weekend. I had a gig cancelled on Saturday, which is a shame, really, but it meant I had a night in with the cats, which is quite nice. And the venue I was meant to be at, it was their cock up when they apologised and gave me two gigs back, one in October, one in December. So that was not a bad turnaround, although it did leave me a bit skinned this week. I was relying on it. But there you go. So I had I had Saturday night off, and then yesterday I went over to Grimesthorpe Castle to go to the Nen Valley Rock Festival. Which was absolutely fantastic. I went over there with Bob Cheatham, who I run the Oundle Ember Sessions with. And me and Bob headed over there. And we got there about midday and we saw some incredible bands. We really did. There's a lot of like early 70s bands there, like Trilogy and Haze and Wishbone Ash. And stuff I hadn't heard of as well. There's also Gypsy's Kiss, who featured the first band that Steve Harris from Iron Maiden was in, his old school friend, is still running the band. That first band had been going since 1974. They were really good, and I met them and had a quick chat after their set. But the highlight for me, obviously, was Solstice, which Alice and Roger know about. They're my favourite band in the country at the moment. I absolutely love them. If you ever get a chance to see them, see Solstice. They are absolutely outstanding. They are so full of joy. If you go to my personal page, you'll see a clip that I did share from their set. And they're just so powerful. And they're joyous, absolutely joyous. You can't help but dance to them as well. And, you know, and Jess, the singer, was blessed. She was like, there are a few prog bands that people can dance to, but no one really knows how to do it because all the songs are in weird timing. They're just amazing and lovely people as well. And I do believe that we might be having them on in Oundle next year. So more news on that another time. Ebony Buckle, who sings for them, she is, she also is a great solo artist. Do check out her stuff. We've had her on at the Ember Sessions. And she's going to be headlining the Soundle, which is on in June next year. So that's been confirmed anyway. And had a quick chat with her. And we also had the wonderful Doris Brendel yesterday. And Doris is absolutely lovely. She's actually running her own radio show now as we speak. She's a DJ for Hard Rock Hell Radio, so that's on now. And you can watch that on Catch Up. She's played us a few times. And she's a great woman. And she obviously played at Tanner Fest. And we got her on at the Ember Sessions on the October 17th. With Peter Jones is also great. And then in January, ourselves, the Wildfires, will be playing with Doris in Leicester. I think it's going to be January the 10th. Probably at the International Centre. We've got to confirm that. I'll be posting information about that soon. So a bit of a plug there, but all this stuff is because I was at the Nen Valley Rock Festival. And it was great. And finishing off last night was the group called Caravan, who I didn't really know a lot about. I did have a quick listen and I was aware of them, you know, and I made myself listen to their first album, so I had a bit of an idea about what they were going to do, and I looked forward to them, and they were brilliant. They were absolutely brilliant. I mean, they're all getting on now. You know, they've been going since the late 60s, so there's a couple of original members, but great characters and still got it, you know, still absolutely got it. So hopefully the Wildfires will still be going when we're their age, you know. Right, speaking of the Wildfires, let's do a track from Angels and Sirens. I don't play this very often, so I was thinking around with it yesterday and I thought... Darkness of the morning, when I open my eyes, thoughts of you come racing in, slip into my mind. The universe is wide, time goes on forever. It's a year, a month, a day ahead, and I'm stuck in there forever. I'm playing it all back, it all goes round and round. A pointless broken record, still a lot of sound. And all the words we wished we'd said, could they have made it right? And all the voices that we heard are slipping through my mind. Wondering who'll replace me, who'll slip into my shoes. You can't take the past away, but the future's set to lose. I'm playing it all back, it all goes round and round. A pointless broken record, still the loudest sound. The universe is wide, time goes on forever. It's a year, a month, a day ahead, and I'm stuck in there forever. It's a pointless broken record, pointless broken record. Pointless broken record, pointless broken record. 1 p.m. and last stop, but 1 p.m. and last stop, but 1 p.m. and last stop, but 1 p.m. and last stop. A chilled version of Pointless Broken Record, which is from the album Angels and Sirens, which you can buy on CD from our web store right now. There is 13 tracks on this, and it's the 2018 album. And you can also listen to it on Spotify and shout at Alexa and it'll play it for you probably as well, or YouTube. But that's a chilled version, which I had a go at, and I quite like that. And, you know, I think that might feature an acoustic album. And that song was born out of anxiety. You know, it was it's all about anxiety, really, about having these thoughts that you just can't get rid of. You know, no matter how hard you try. You know, when you're having an anxiety attack, it's just, you know, I'm sure many of you have experienced them. I've experienced them most of my life, and I've always battled with it since I was very young. And it wasn't until I was much older that I realised what they were. I didn't know what I was going through. I wasn't aware that I was having anxiety until probably about 15 years ago when I was going to counselling. And it's horrible when you can't switch off from a thought that just goes round and round. That's what that song's about. It's a weird one because I actually wrote it. I was in a relationship with someone and we had quite an amicable split, really. And we're still great friends now. And I just couldn't stop thinking of various moments, you know, and it was just really weird. And I was wondering who she was with and all this, even though it was perfectly amicable, it was bizarre. I've had bad breakups where I've had those feelings, but that was through an amicable one. So it can be very random, you know, things can trigger things. And, that's what that song's about, really, is about those moments. And a Pointless Broken Record. Do check out the full band version on the album. Yeah, and on the album, a link here. On that track, it features Jake Patrick on drums, Bob Dabrowski on bass, and Vasilis D on guitar. Hi Sally, thanks for tuning in. And we also had Autumn Dawn Leader playing on keyboards and guest vocals. It was Autumn's birthday yesterday, And I really wanted to be there, but I cocked it up a little bit because I thought Autumn's thing was in the afternoon. I was going to go to her thing, and then I was going to go on to the Nan Valley Rock thing, but it all got cocked up, and Autumn's thing was in the evening. So I couldn't be there. So I felt a bit disappointed about that. But you can't be in two places at the same time, can you? So, happy birthday yesterday, because your birthday gig yesterday, Autumn. I don't know if you're watching this or you tune in. You're probably recovering, maybe. But yeah, it looks like it was a good gig at Musician yesterday for your 50th. Autumn appears on this album quite a lot, on keyboards and vocals. And I'm just going to line you up the song with her performing on it for you, if I can get my computer to work. Gabby, hello from a quiet forecourt. Jamie is printing labels. I am working. Hi, Gabby. Oh, I've got two of my work colleagues there. I was just saying earlier about working at the garage, and Gabby is still there. So, yeah, I hope I can entertain you for the last bit of your shift, Gabby, anyway. Right, let's find that track I wanted to play. So, yeah. I'm going to play you a track with Autumn on it, like I just said. And this is actually a live version of a song called Stratigraphic Heart, which is the title track of our first album. And Jake's last gig with us was in, when was it? I think it was early 2018, I think. Something like that, or 2019. Early 2019. And we did a gig at Musician, and it was recorded live. And this is a track from it. And it features Autumn on the keyboards and vocals to Stratigraphic Heart. So let's see if we can get it to work. Here we go. Anyway, this is all about my other day job. This is the title track of our first album. This is called Stratigraphic Heart. Fresh winter's morning, loads wheelbarrows from the shed. We are up to warm and ready for a busy day ahead. We take mattocks and shovels, walk over by the hedge. It's a big yellow machine ready to dig further in the trench. And this is who I am. This is how I came to be. The stratigraphic heart, it makes the whole of me. Drug sites from Weimar to Dublin, in the field, in the town. Everywhere tells its own story, in the clay, in the ground. Bone fragments and flint scatters, and the shirts of pottery. In my hands and the soil, Stratigraphic Heart, recorded in early 2019. Jake Patrick's farewell gig. Got the bloody, can't find the album cover. I was going to show you the album. There we go. That's the album, Stratigraphic Heart. And yeah, but that's the live version. And if you want to hear that live version, if you go on to our Bandcamp, or you go to the streaming channels, it's on the live EP called Morningless Live. And I think that's the best version. I think it's better than the studio version. What also adds to it is outstanding, and we really rock it up a bit. The studio version is a lot more mellow. The studio version features Marshall Gill from Blackballed, and Leon, who was in Blackballed as well. And yeah, so they're two very different versions. But if you don't know the backstory about that, that track is all about my time in archaeology, and it sums up the feeling of working on an archaeological site. And it was a career I had for over 30 years, and at the time I was writing it, I was still in that profession, but I retired from it nearly 6 years ago now. I do miss it. I miss the people. I miss the vibe. I miss using my brain outside and getting my hands dirty and being in touch with archaeology and the past and stuff. But I just took it as far as I wanted to go with it, really, and I didn't want to work outside anymore. As you get older, working outside in all weathers, just gets harder and harder, So yeah, it's that song's there anyway, and it's a testament to my time in archaeology, and I love that version. So anyway, I thought I'd play that for Autumn. Happy birthday, Autumn. I might actually share that so people can hear it, can listen to it, and wish her a happy birthday on there as well. I did actually say, this is a quick one. I did actually send her a birthday gift. If you go over to Autumn Dawn Leader Songstress, her group page or page, you'll see a link to donate for her album funding. She's in the process of completing her album at Deadline Studios with Adam Ellis. And you can donate some money to help her complete it. I think if you donate a certain amount, you get a CD as well. So, yeah, looking forward to hearing that. I know Kevin Hewitt's featuring on that. And, yeah, it's going to be good. If you're tuning in on Catch Up, thank you very much for joining us. You don't have to watch this live. Some of my favourite live streamers out there. Over the past, I've used them like podcasts. You know, watch these things anytime you like. And if you do, go to our website, steviejones.com. It's a page called Live Streams, and you can catch up on one that's going right back to the beginning of time. There's another 53. Wow. But there aren't that many people streaming anymore. I mean, Roger and Alice, I know, tune in regularly to Fish on Friday, which is, according to him, that was his last one. But I don't believe that for a word. I think when he's on tour this autumn, he will be popping up. And Ryan Adams, who I love, didn't seem to be doing it anymore. And yeah, where are they all? They seem to be the last man standing. Let's play a song. Another song, actually, off Angels and Sirens that I chose to play for you tonight. And it's one I don't do very often at all, and I should do. I'm going to play you the closing track on the album. And this is written by my late friend, Mr. Ian Babington. It's called Easy Now. Off your working shoes, put your feet up by the fire, watch the sunset pass the towers. What I can bear to lose is not everything some would desire. To me, you're perfect and you're mine. Easy now. It's raining out. The lights are low. Easy Now, the last track off Angels and Sirens, written by my late friend Mr. Ian Babington. Ian was a lovely guy, used to come to a lot of my open mics when I first started doing them in Leicester, and that's how I met him. And we were both big Article Works fans as well, so we bonded over that. And when I supported Ian McNabb at the Musician, I supported Ian a couple of times at the Musician, but one of the times Ian got up and we sang that song together, actually. And he was absolutely chuffed to support Ian McNabb. And Yeah, it was very sad when we lost Ian. He wasn't even 50, and he was such a lovely guy. And we miss him. We miss him. We do miss him. So that's why I wanted to end the album with that, because it's such a beautiful song, you know. It's just a beautiful love song, you know, and it just sets a lovely picture. And that song remains, you know. God bless him. Right, I'm going to do another cover for you now, I think. Here we are. Yeah, say me and Ian Babington were big fans of classical works. I don't know if Ian was a fan of the next band I'm going to cover for you, but he might have been. I can't remember. I do know that this next band, they did play a lot of the Princess Charlotte, where Ian and I used to go to some of the gigs. Back in the day when it was open. Let's do it open. This is a song written by an Irish band called The Fat Lady Sings. I was a huge fan of them in the early 90s. They did, they only did two albums and then they split up. And this is a song off their second album called Drunken Logic. And the girls go out, now it's a deed. And the boys stay in, now it's too late. Still I fall in love six times a night. And vain on sight, vain on sight. And this bottle laughs back in my face. See how easily I lose my place. And the way I look tonight's a crime. Where does the time go? Where has the time gone? But if I held you in my arms again, this time I'd never let you go. And I would feel the universe for you, and I would let you know. We don't leave ourselves with many things, just in letters, leases, rings and rings. When the last one sold, all of us are gone. We don't belong here, we don't belong here. If I held you in my arms again, this time I'd never let you go. And I'd feel the universe for you, and I would let you know. They cannot dust me down. Things will always have turned out about this way. Where there's an up, there'll always be a down, you say. Where there's an up, there'll always be a down. If I held you in my arms again, this time I'd never let you go. I would feel the universe for you, and I would let you know. And if I held you in my arms again, this time I'd never let you go. And I would feel the universe for you, and I would let you know. But That he sings Drunkard Logic. I love that song. I love it so much. That song really, really spoke to me at the time. I don't know, when I first heard it, I was living in London and I was going out on my own a lot, you know what I mean? And I was drinking a lot, you know, and I've always been I'm less romantic now, but I was always a very sensitive romantic and you know, that song's kind of like looking back on a lost loved one and wondering, you know, and thinking about them and wondering if you could ever fix it, you know. It's just, and the more you drink, the deeper you go into that kind of morass, that area, you know. It's just a fantastic song, fantastic. And yeah, I think if I do the Songs and Stories acoustic album, that'll probably feature on it, you know. It's they actually did reform. They've done a couple of reunion gigs and I think they might even be doing a new album. But they haven't so far done anything on these shores, I don't think. Sometimes it's weird going back seeing bands from certain eras, you know, and those songs meant a lot for me. They're all very kind of broken love songs, I guess, which are some of my favourite music, as you know, does tackle that kind of topic, you know, romance and working your way through that journey, you know, to the other side. And all those types of songs have helped me, you know, umpteen times trying to work out my emotions. And Fat Lady Sings albums have been there for me, those first two albums. And when I went to go and see a band called Unbelievable Truth last summer, they played at the Bush Hall in Islington, and they reformed. Now they've got a song called Almost Here, and it was an album that I listened to a lot when I was having a really, really bad time, you know, proper full-on kind of semi-nervous breakdown when I look back on it. And the album was, I used to stick it in the car on my way to work, and it was like my kind of audio Bible. And I started listening to it when I heard that they were reforming it again. I thought, I've got to see them, I'll listen to it again. And I love the album, but when I went to go and see them, it moved me so much. It kind of took me back to that place again. It was like a big trigger. And I was going through a bad time last summer as well, emotionally, with some romance stuff going on that was hard to deal with. And the whole thing was a massive trick, and it took me right back to 1997, when although 98, late 90s anyway, when I first discovered the album. It took me back too deep, and I don't think it helped me, you know, in terms of getting out this trigger. And sometimes it's difficult going back, you know. And I think you've got to be careful. There's certain albums that I find very difficult to listen to again. I'm not sure that I'll jump back in and listen to that Unbelievable Truth album again, particularly having seen them, you know. It just took me back too much. And maybe you've got albums like that. Post them on here. Let me know if you've got any news that you find really hard to go back and listen to again, you know, because it just reminds you too much of certain memories and times. I know with Kate Bush, I find it very difficult to listen to her music. I think all of her albums just are so emotional. They just take me right back to that moment again. Hounds of Love reminds me of 1986 being in the snow. It's just too close to the bone, you know. Is it Essential Love? Essential World, that one reminds me of a relationship. Red Shoes again reminds me of being in my mum's kitchen at a certain time. It's like a time machine, you know. I think Rob Halford from Judas Priest said that, actually. But one of the great things about music, it is like a fucking time machine. It will take you back to that time when you first heard it, you know. But some of those albums are more sensitive than others. And some will remind us of great times and we don't mind playing them over and over again. Or some we might have kind of gone beyond that journey, you know. I think Roger and Alice will probably agree with me that there's certain Marillion records that are certainly like that, you know. Certain Misplaced Childhood will always take me back to the first time I heard it, you know. And same with Clutching at Straws, sending you back to drinking in Kettering in the kind of, you know, 1988, you know. And I can picture the people in the bar, you know, when I was there. I'd listen to the album before I went out, go to my local, and just all the images and characters that are featured on the album, they'd be there in my pub too, you know. Yeah, Charlotte says music is so amazing, the world would be boring without it. True, very true. Roger says, as Bruce Hornsby said, don't look back, you should never look back, Boys of Summer. Yeah, it's very true. But we do look back, you know, it's just curiosity. And music is like a fucking time machine, is all I'll say. I think with the new album getting there, it is a journey, because it does take you through some difficult emotions with the album, but there is healing at the end. And the new single, Genuine, which many of you have seen the video of. If you haven't, do look on our page or YouTube, look at the video for Genuine. It's got nearly 2,500 hits in just over a week, which is fucking amazing. And it's up on all the streaming channels to listen to now. That is the healing moment at the end of the album, you know, but before it's a journey. If you haven't heard the album, you can buy a copy from the website on CD. I know Fred's just bought one, and thank you, Fred. I hope it arrives safely in Arran, all up in the Isle of Arran, up there on the off the coast of Scotland. You can listen to it also on Bandcamp, but buy a copy from there if you like. Just stream it, preview stream it. There's three streams you get there, but it will be released with all the streaming on October the 1st. So yeah, we've got quite a few gigs coming up to help promote the album. The next one, be nice to see some of you there if you're local, can make it. It's on Saturday the 28th of September at the Ship in Oundle, and that's going to be good. It's only £5 to get in for that one. And yeah, it's a Saturday night, and we've got friends Unit 5 playing and Gary Lee Ward playing as well. It's in the back room there. Looking forward to that. It's our first time we played there. And then the rest of the tour features Friday the 4th, we're at Katie Fitzgerald's in Stourbridge. Saturday the 5th, we're at Percy's Cafe Bar in Whitchurch. Yeah, up in Shropshire. They're both with our friends, the Bitter Lemons. Friday the 8th of November, we're at Mama Liz in Stamford with Stephen Tanner, Liam Vincent and the Odd Foxes and Tony Barker. Saturday the 23rd of November, we are at the Jolly Brewer in Lincoln for Musicians Against Homeless Benefit gig. And then to the end of November, we're playing in Banbury. And on the 29th and the 30th, we're playing in Bournemouth. So that's our gigs for the rest of the year. We've got some nice gigs to announce very soon with our friends Blackpool and Autumn Saints. That's going to be next spring. So keep an eye out for that. That'll be announced very soon, the next few weeks. Quite excited about that. Because we're playing some nice venues. So, I'm going to finish off with an audio track, actually. I had some sad news, some very sad news yesterday, which kind of hit me. I was just on my way to the Nen Valley Rock Festival, and I looked at my phone, and I found out that a good friend of mine, Mel Peake, passed away. He had a battle with cancer, and he didn't make it. And I thought he was kind of like on the recovery. And it must have turned for the worse, and it escalated quickly. I was very sad I haven't seen him. So my condolences go out to his wife Sherry and all his friends and family. Mel was an absolutely lovely guy. He was a singer. His main job actually was, performing wise, he was a Frank Sinatra impersonator. But that wasn't just, that's one thing he did. I mean, he did full swing band gigs and stuff like that. And he was a total showman, you know. But he did write original material. And during lockdown, I've got fond memories of him sending me some stuff that he'd done. And he actually released a single, which I'll share at some point, actually. And he was very disappointed he didn't get as many views as he would have liked. But it was a good record, and he sorted it all out himself on GarageBand and sorted out all the instruments and stuff. Amazing. And but I got to know Mel through an events magazine that I was working for, and Mel took it over. He took the business over, and I helped him run it for a little while. And we used to deliver the magazine events on all around Northamptonshire, Bedfordshire, surrounding counties. And you know, getting advertising, getting bands to advertise their stuff in it, and I'd write some reviews for him and interviews and things like that, articles, and then I'd help him deliver it. So it was good times, you know. But as things changed, and you know, the internet came in, and then obviously lockdown, he did wind it down, and then him and Sherry just concentrated on being agents mainly, as well as Mel's performing. And they still have been booking acts right up to now. So I'm not quite sure what Sherry will do with the business, whether or not she'll continue to do the bookings. But there's a lot of artists out there that they've helped over the years, the Mel and Sherry have helped, and they'll be very sad too. So very sad to hear about Mel Peak. What I thought I'd do is I'd end tonight's show with a song for him. Just all about the love of music, really. And, you know, because Mel, you know, that was his life, like me, you know, that was his life, music, you know, music events, performing. And he's very passionate about it. This is the B-side of Coming From The Rain radio edit. If you go to Spotify and you click on it, this is like the extra track. And a lot of you might have missed it, but it's an acoustic version of This Is My Church. All about love and music, and this is for Mel Peak. Turn the speaker on, might bloody help.
Brought up in the country, walking my dog out in the field. Found a new religion to the sound of the walkman connecting with me. First gig was in '81. I saw the whole life at the NEC. My ears, they rang for days, and I thank my father for the fire it gave me. This is my church, these are the roots of me. This is my church, these are the roots of me. Takes my uncle made for me. Robert Johnson and Neil Young, Hendrix, Kraftwerk and David Bowie. David Bowie, he filled my head. Every album was a brand new journey. Mom and Dad, three Supertramp, Van the Man, Queen, Floyd and Joni. And this is my church, these are the roots of me. And this is my church, these are the roots of me. 6 years old, down a yellow brick road. The sofa was my piano. On a Thursday night, with a plastic guitar, wanting to be my bowler. The ground of the punk rock style. Death Cab for Bauhaus. Friday as I have my tea. Well, this is my church, he's on the ropes for me. This is my church, these are the roots of me. So we headed to Brixton, 200 pumps on a southbound train. We headed down to Bragwell Park for the Spear and the Down and the NMA. Passion in the family they gave. Bought a bass and formed a band, ignited the fire that burns in me today. This is my church, these are the roots of me. This is my church, these are the roots of me. This is my church, 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 this is my church.
Church acoustic version. And if you look on the streaming channels and look out for Coming From The Rain radio edit, that's the kind of B-side. And it's a good little version. That we recorded that in the part of the Clarity and Dust sessions, I think. No, it was just after that. Yeah, around that time anyway. No, we actually recorded start of the year before we did the Getting There sessions, so we could release Coming From The Rain as a single. And it's got Alfie on guitar, Bob on bass, and Adam Ellis on percussion. So yeah, chuffed out that turned out. It's from Mel Peak, you know, God bless him. And yeah, nice little acoustic version there. Moving ahead into next Monday, I'm not sure if I'm going to be doing a live stream or not, because I've actually got a bit of a road trip. I forgot to mention earlier on that I'm playing in Worcester next Sunday, solo acoustic gig. At the, what's it called, the Social Beer Brewing Company, it's called, at 6 o'clock, part of the Worcester Music Festival. So I'm all weekend in the town, and I'm playing on the Sunday at 6 o'clock. So if you're in Worcester, come and see me. I'm going to be camping for a couple of days with my friend Sam, and then I'm heading down to Bath and Bristol to catch up with a couple of friends there. And I'm very excited because we're going to see Mr. Ryan Adams live in Bath, and that's gonna be amazing. Just bloody hope his shirt turns up, because he's a bit prone to cancelling gigs sometimes, but yeah, it's gonna be amazing. He did about a 3-hour show of acoustic stuff, so I'm looking forward to that. That's on the Tuesday, and after that I've got 3 days camping. Well, when I say camping, I'm staying my first time ever in a camping pod with a sea view in North Devon. That's gonna be amazing. So I'll be sharing some pictures from that. But whether or not I can do a live stream next Monday, I don't know, because I'll be on a campsite. It will depend on the what I'm up to and what the reception's like. So we'll play that one by ear. But in the meantime, thank you very much for tuning in again, whether it have been live or on catch up. I really appreciate you all tuning in and listening to my music, and I hope I give something to you on a Monday evening or whatever you are listening to it. Make sure you keep going out there and supporting gigs, particularly the grassroots one. Don't worry about the stadium gigs. They've got enough money already, that's what I say. There's some great gigs out there in small venues. Go and see them, they're like a tenner, and you'll have a great night, trust me. And, you know, you could go to like 10 grassroots gigs as opposed to going and seeing one stadium gig. Think of that. If you want to put anything in the tip jar, or buy an album, please do, or just keep checking out my music. There's some really good back catalogue stuff there, stuff I've been making over the years, and some of you may have never heard it. Do check it out. And if you've got any requests for me to play anything in future streams, do let me know. Thank you very much. Thank you, Alice, Charlotte, Gabby, Roger, Red. I shall catch you all very soon. Take care.